The man behind Franco's Italy is serving up classic eggplant parmigiana. Welcome back, Chef. I like those gestures already.
Parmigiana.
That's it. You have to put the emphasis there for
Chef. This is eggplant parmigiana.
Ooh. This is it right here.
This is the classic. Now, what happens when people make eggplant parmesan, they do something wrong with it.
Mm-hmm.
They don't bake it. They don't do this double cook that you have to do to make sure that it's nice and tender.
Yes.
Sometimes it tastes a little green. This is eggplant. Look how green this is. Okay.
Yeah.
This is fresh.
Okay.
So you want to cut it in these slices like this. You're going to dip it first in your cheese, which is usually pecorino or parmigiano.
Okay.
And then you're going to go into your egg wash and then, or into the eggs and then some breadcrumbs. Plain breadcrumbs, please.
Plain, no plain breadcrumbs.
Breadcrumbs.
Do you,
don't know
hear
what
he's saying?
Tell you what breadcrumbs taste like. Okay. So now we do this and then you're going to fry it real quick.
Okay.
Just to get it brown. So this is what the second part of it looks
it
like.
It looks gorgeous.
Good.
You use these for an appetizer, a little aioli, whatever.
Yeah, it looks like you could eat those by itself.
You could.
You're always thinking about us. You're always taking good care of us. You are.
So now, third step, the bake-off. So when you're finished with this, let me get my little panel here.
Look at that. Look at that.
So we're going to break it loose a little bit like this.
Oh, that looks so good, by the way.
When you're making eggplant parmigiana, and by the way, the name parmigiana is not necessarily about Parmesan cheese, right? Parmigiana is a Sicilian slang that means stacked wood. If you look at your parmigiana, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's stacked.
It is stacked. We see
that's how you want it to look, just like that, okay?
That looks gorgeous.
Oh, so it's supposed to have layers.
It's supposed to have layers.
Got you.
It's supposed to be stacked.
So, now, Chef, what about the simplicity of this, though?
Easy breezy.
Easy breezy.
A little bit of breadcrumbs, some cheese. You're going to put together what your favorite pomodoro sauce, pasta sauce.
Mm-hmm.
Cheese on top, you're finished. Bakes in 45 minutes.
That's it?
Don't be threatened or confused about cooking like this. This is the easy stuff, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna even show you one that's even easier, right?
So what do you have there in the pan?
Is grilled eggplant.
Okay.
Or grilled polenta, excuse me. What we've done is just a little bit of mushrooms, onions, some fresh parsley.
Yes.
Think outside the box when it comes to going vegetarian or going meatless or Lent or whatever it happens
to be. Right.
You don't just have to grab a cheese pizza. You do something like this. Easy, right? And look at the quality of this food. It's incredible stuff. This will come across with nice savory flavor. We're using mushrooms because of the fall, right? Go seasonal with these items. It's going to be fantastic. Here.
What you got there?
Don't be afraid.
Oh, the eggplant.
It's an eggplant.
That's it.
Don't be afraid.
But that looks like it would be something intimidating to us to prepare something with eggplant.
You always hear about, slicing the eggplant, putting it in salt, doing all this crazy stuff that you can. They talk about it sometimes being bitter.
Yeah.
Hey, I've done it both ways. You don't have to. You don't have to get too crazy with it. Slice it, fry it, boom, you're done. Okay.
That's it?
Easy stuff. Now, what kind of wine? Montepulciano di Bruzzo. Easy for both of these.
What does it taste like for the wine?
So it has a fresher taste to it. It's not oaky.
Yes.
Not like California. We're in good shape.
Yeah.
Okay. We like that. We like that. We're there with you every step of the way.
Especially when you add some wine.
Should we pop some open right now?
Where are the glasses?
And then always we want to have something fresh on it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Parsley, herbs, something that brings some life to it. Something that's going to bring some, we talk about the gremolata, something that's live in your food.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Always, always. That, this is nice when you're cooking this. The onions are marvelous. But bring something live to it. You got yourself a great dish. Okay.
There always seems to be, Chef, with your foods, a story that goes with it.
Right.
Is there a story behind this?
Well, the story, again, goes by the name. Like we talked about, the false narrative about it being Parmesan cheese as opposed to the Sicilian dialect meaning stacked wood, right? Mm-hmm. So eggplant took the place of meat. You got to remember with food, meatless things, most really great cuisines are plant-based,
right?
That's how they were. People were poor. Peasants ate a lot of plants. Carnival,
okay,
was the festival of eating meat. Mm-hmm. Carne vale.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's when they ate it.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so eat normally like this, a little carnival when you're done.
You really seem to get into the history of the foods as well.
I do, yeah.
Yeah.
I like it. I like knowing about all the foods that we have.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. This recipe will be on WREG.com.
Right.
It looks great.
That's it.
Thank you.
And we can also come out and find you
Anywhere.
That's it.
He's everywhere.
Go to francositaly.com. You want the recipe, go to Franco's Italy at Gmail. And what else we got? Facebook.
That's
We've
it.
Got Instagram. We've got it all.
We got everything.
You're everywhere. You're right.
The man.
We're going to take a break. Get ready to dig
and
in.
Eat this.
Chef Franco, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you.